Hello, you're welcome. I'm Caroline Arjuna Atenyi Chibuka. I'm here today to talk about the most historical and important event, the Empango that happens in Bunyoro Kingdom, that is in Uganda, East Africa. Today I'm here with an expert, a historian and a teacher in this field. You're most welcome.
Thank you, Caroline, and hello everyone. My name is Hadijah Ksembo Mbabazi Atoki, Msitakati. I'm a history teacher and I happen to be the current chair of Bunyoro Kitara Development Association in the UK. I'm glad to be here.
Can you explain to our viewers what Empango means and why it happens every yearly, is it?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline. The Empango is an annual activity that is currently celebrated once every year in Bunyoro Kitara Development, in Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom. It originates from the fact that in the past, Bunyoro Kitara, you all know it used to be a mighty kingdom within the Interlacustrine region. And it originates from the fact that once upon a time, that royal clan of Tebamulindi belonged to the Abasita clan. But it so happened that there was famine and some women were giving birth and they needed food, and the Abasita clan did not have food. And yet the Babito people had food. So due to the importance the Basita people attached to their women, they decided to exchange their drum authority in for them to get food from the Babito. So they got food and at the same time they were given millet, which was food, and up to now, we take millet to be our traditional dish. Now, when they did that, the first time the Babito got the clan, they had to drum it to show that they've now got the authority. So you'll find that for every king in Bunyoro, the first time they are coming on the throne, they have to drum that Tebamulindi drum. It's like a royal regalia.
Let's just get this clear. You just said every clan, when they're coming on the throne, do you want to mean that the Bunyoro Kingdom leadership rotates just like the Busoga Kingdom, or we have one particular clan that rules throughout the reign of Bunyoro Kingdom?
Thank you. It's the Babito dynasty that is in power. But if you look at the current kingdom, the current king, Rukiravasaija Gutamba Iguru, he's the 27th king. So for every king that has come on the throne, he has to drum that as a symbol of acquiring the sovereignty of ruling that kingdom. But what happens when the king dies, which we call Okutuza, that drum is put upside down until the next king comes on the throne, then they will put it up again for that king to. So it's the Empango in general is a kind of celebration that happens to remember, like the birthday of that person, the day that person got onto the throne. And previously we would have like those celebrations twice a year during the harvesting season. Still it goes back to the history of how there was an exchange between food and the real. But because of resources and because of the changing environment, I think they decided now it will always be only once a year. But it has a lot of rituals that are involved.
Okay, that's a good point. So what I gather from your explanation is that Bunyoro, the Babito, got the leadership from the Basita because of interchanging food, because a woman needed to eat and she was there was harvest. I mean, not harvest, there was
famine.
And that's how the Basita lost their leadership to the Babito.
Yes.
Cool. That's good. Thank you. So explain more about this Empango. How is it done? Mm. How does the day begin and how does the day end of the Empango?
Thank you, Caroline. It is a process that takes so many months when they are preparing, because it is during that day that the people in Bunyoro come together at that place. But what is more important is historical is for us to know what kind of rituals are involved, especially on that very day. The rituals begin as early as 3 a.m.,
wow,
we are told. And during that day of the Empango celebration, you'll see the Basita gathering at a hill,
wow,
with their drum, the Tivamlinde. Now that drum, and for them to gather there, it still shows the importance that they actually had it before, and up to today they are respected, that they will be the first people to have it there, to drum it. And after that, then a procession from that hill will go through Mugavante, you know, the gate there, and there will be people following until the drum is given to the king. Okay. And in that royal procession, we've got different people involved that accompany the drum when the Basita are taking it there. One of the clan leaders of the Abasuli heads the procession. And among those, there are other clans also, like Abahamba. Abahamba will be carrying a rake with a sack of millet there, showing how we treasure farming in the kingdom of Bunyoro Kitara. And among the other rituals is that previously, we are told it would take 9 days. Different activities happening at different levels,
yes,
for 9 days. And we are also told that the king, before the Empango, would sleep on one side and not on, you know, he would be meant to sleep on only one side, yeah, for 9 days. So there is the figure nine becomes a very important day. But currently, the Empango celebrations actually takes 4 days. The 2 days are held at Karuzika, which is the main palace of Bunyoro Kitara. And then there is one day where they go to the Queen Mother's residence. Some rituals are performed there. And then the other one is they go to the Omkondwa's place. The Omkondwa was the fortune teller. There's a history around that. That fortune teller from the Mkondwa is the one who prophesied that Rukidi Mpuga the First would be the first king of the Bunyoro dynasty, and indeed it happened. So up to today, we still cherish that. And because he was the first person to drum on the Tibamlinde, so that one is also part of the 4 days function that,
wow,
takes place. Yeah,
that's a big, that's no wonder we have it is a very important and historical function. We are not speaking in Bunyoro right now because we are trying to explain this whole event, this important historical event happening in Bunyoro. So we want people to know what and why it is performed. Anything else that you want to tell viewers before we have a break?
Thank you, Caroline. I would actually want to emphasize the point that the Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom is the oldest kingdom is one of the biggest kingdoms, especially in the intercostrain region. Biggest in the sense that all the other kingdoms like Buganda and Busoga, they actually emerged from Bunyoro. We've got a brief history there that Rukidi Mpuga's brother, Kato, disobeyed his brother and he went to Buganda. And when he went to Buganda, he went with one of the royal drums. And if you follow the history of Buganda, you'll find that the royal drum that is called Mujaguzo actually came from Bunyoro with Kato, who later changed his name to Kimera. Kimera meaning it came from a Bunyoro that I have germinated. So when Kato went to Buganda, he proclaimed himself the king there with the drum, the Mjagzo, and then he said, now you cannot touch me, I've germinated. Mezere, nyemereze. So okay, that's where it comes from. And this, in the same way, the princes from Bunyoro are the princes that went and established the kingdoms in Busoga. So you'll find that even up to today, when the Busoga are being buried, they actually face Bunyoro where they came from. So there's a lot of history related to that. But I'd like also to inform the viewers that Bunyoro Kitara Dvo, I mean Bunyoro Kitara Kingdom, actually ruled up to Tanganyika as far as Karagwe. So, and the Babito dynasty is not the first one. We started with the Batembuzi, the Bachwezi, and the Babito dynasty. So it's all around our history.
Isn't that amazing how wonderful this history that we all do not know is being told today? And another, so is this event normally held on the 11th of June or do the dates in change?
Thank you, Caroline. The reason why it is held on the 11th is because of the current king, Rukira Basaija Gutamba Solomon Iguru, when he was getting onto the throne again. Remember, after 1966, the kingdoms were abolished. And when they were abolished, the main royal drum, Tubamlinde, had to be turned upside down. It remained like that. Mm. And now when he was being enthroned again, that's the day he remembers. That's the day, his first day to drum on it. And that's why we are celebrating it every year on the 11th of June. But it can change, like I told you, that previously they would celebrate it twice a year and during harvest season.
Yes. Wonderful. Thank you very much, Hadijah Kisembo, for that rich history that you've just given to us. And for now, we'll go for a break and we'll come back later.